So let's look at how you can use tables in PI Coresight. So just like before, I'm going to drag over one of my search results. In this case, I'm going to drag over the boiler, which is the PI AF asset. And when I do that, again, I'm presented with a list of how do I want to see it, and this time I'm going to choose table. So PI Coresight is going out to the PI AF system and pulling in every attribute that's defined about that boiler. So I can see water, model, manufacturer, and so on. I can see the description of each of those items, and I can also see the current value, the engineering units, and then I can see average, max, standard deviation, minimum, and a sparkline trend. And all of these calculations and the trend are based off of the display time range that I've selected. In this case, it's 8 hours. So what can I do with this table? I can do a lot of things. I can customize it. I can customize the data that I'm looking at. So if I wanted to remove some of these values that never change, like the model manufacturer, all I have to do is highlight the row, and you'll see I get a little X, which lets me remove the item from the table. So I'm going to highlight the row, click the X, and that removes that static data. Okay, what else can I do? I can rearrange the order of these columns just by clicking and dragging. So if I want trend to be one of the first things I see, I can move that up to the front, maybe engineering units also up to the front. Okay, so that's totally customizable by you, and this is going to remember your settings every time you come in. So every time you add a new table, it's going to remember the last way you configured it. Now another thing you can do is you can actually determine which columns show up. And the way you do that is you click this little gear button. And when I do that, I'm presented with a list of all the available columns. So I can pick and choose which ones I want to see. So perhaps I don't want to see standard deviation, I don't really care. But the rest of these are good. So I can remove standard deviation, and now he's not on my list of columns. So that's pretty interesting. Now, I can also add other things to this table. So if I wanted to have a table for all of the boilers under this particular cracking process, I could select my other boiler and drag him on here. And there you go. So we've got the boiler 235 data on here now too. And just like I did with the last boiler, I'm going to remove the static information so we don't have to spend time looking at that. Okay, so that's a little bit about tables. They're very flexible, they're very customizable. You can add or remove whatever data you want, and you can actually organize this information any way you want to. Another thing that you can do with tables is you can actually sort the columns. So just by clicking on the column name, it will sort from low to high or high to low, depending on how you've toggled this. So you can see how that goes. So that's a little bit about tables in PI Coresight.